Hi friends, in this video we are going to see the application of Norton's theorem in order to solve a problem. So let's have a problem. So in this circuit, I am having a voltage source of 10 volt, one more voltage source of 5 volt, and resistances are of 5, 2, 1 and 4 ohm. And these are the terminals given A and B, across which we have to replace the entire circuit as a Norton's equivalent circuit. So the heading is find equivalent Norton's circuit between terminals A and B. If you see properly, what I need to do to get IN, I need to short circuit these two points and get a current, but it is very difficult here because it may give rise to a three-dimensional structure which is very difficult to analyze. So what I will do, I will redraw the circuit, keeping all the concepts as it is. So my first step over here, before applying Norton's theorem, redrawing the circuit. See how I am going to redraw the same circuit but with a different orientation. I will keep this part of the circuit as it is. So here it is 10 volt, 5 ohm, 2 ohm with terminal A. Now what I am going to do? From this 2 ohm, I will consider this branch and I will draw like this. From this point, I have 1 ohm resistance connected to B terminal. So it is like this. 1 ohm connected to B terminal. From B, 4 ohm resistance branch will start. So this is 4 ohm. And this end of a resistance is connected to positive terminal of 5 volt battery. So it is like this. Positive is connected to 4 ohm and this negative will go. So same circuit I have redraw like this. Why I have done this? Because it is very easy to analyze now. So the step number 1 is calculation of IN. What we need to do for that? We need to connect A and B points by a straight line, a short circuit link. So here only I will replace it with a short circuit link like this. And I need to find out current flowing through this. So for this purpose, I will use mesh analysis, because mesh analysis is the simplest technique while solving Norton's theorem. In subsequent videos, we will solve more numericals where this concept will be clear. So right now there are three loops, so three currents I will get. This is I1, I2 and I3. As per the direction of currents, I will get a voltage drops. Now all the elements are having a voltages associated with it. So let's apply KVL to loop number 1. I will start from this point. So from here to here there is no element. Here plus minus. So it's minus 2 I1. Minus plus. plus 2i2 plus minus minus 5i1 minus plus plus 10 equal to 0. If I simplify this, I will get minus 7i1 plus 2i2 equal to minus 10, equation number 1. Similarly, I can apply KVL to loop number 2. So for this, I will start from this point. No element is counted here, plus minus. So it's minus I2, minus plus, it's plus I3. No element over here, plus minus, so it's minus 2i2 once again, and minus plus, plus 2i1, since there is no battery in this loop, constant is equal to 0. If I simplify, I will get 2i1 minus 3i2 plus I3 equal to 0, equation number 2. Similarly, I can apply KVL to loop 3. Loop 3, I will start from this point. So in this direction, minus plus is the voltage rise, plus 5 volt, plus minus, minus 4i3, plus minus, minus I3, minus plus, plus I2 equal to 0. If I simplify, I will get I2 minus 5I3 equal to minus 5, equation number 3. If I solve all these three equations, I will get I1 as 1.9231 ampere, I2 as 1.7308 ampere, and I3 equal to 1.3462 ampere. Now how to decide IN? Go back to the circuit. If you see over here, I want this current from B to A or A to B. So I2 is satisfying that and it is in this direction. So I can say IN is nothing but I2, which is equal to 1.7308 ampere, and I am considering the positive value. The positive value is from B to A. So here I will write from B to A. Step number 1 is over. Let's go to the second step, that is calculation of RN. Second step is a calculation of RN. For this, we need to do three things. One is, we need to open circuit RL. Second, current sources need to be replaced by open circuit, and voltage sources need to be replaced by short circuit. In our case, there is no load resistance given, so it's already open. So no need to mention it. We are having voltage sources and 10 volt and 5 volt. Those voltage sources need to be replaced by short circuited. So if you do this modification, the circuit will be like this. So we replace 10 volt by short. Similarly, 5 volt is also short circuited. So I will get circuit like this with terminals A and B, across which we have to find out RN. And resistances are 5, 2, 1 and 4 ohm. this 2 and 5 are in parallel because those resistances are forming a loop. 2 into 5 divided by 2 plus 5. That will give you answer 10 divided by 7, which is 1.4286 ohm. Similarly, this 1 and 4 are also in parallel. So the answer is 1 into 4 divided by 1 plus 4. So it is 4 divided by 5, 0.8 ohm. So if I redraw the circuit, I will get two resistances connected in series, which finally comes between points A and B. So it's a 1.4286 and this is 0.8 comes in series. So I can directly say Rn, which is nothing but Rab, series combination of 0.8 and 1.4286, which will give you Rn as 2.2286 ohm. So second step is also over. Now third step is Norton's equivalent circuit. So as per the theorem, it will have a current source parallel with a resistance. Current source is called as Norton's current, which is In. In our case, it is 1.7308 ampere. Resistance is Rn, which is Norton's resistance. The value we got is 2.2286 ohm. Now, current we got is from B to A. So, in order to get a current from B to A, here I should mark this point as B and this point as A. Since load resistance is not given, so no need to perform the step number 4. So, this will be our final answer, where we have replaced entire circuit by a simple current source with a resistance across it. In subsequent videos, we will see more numericals based on Norton's theorem. Thank you.